So, as I mentioned earlier, the question of moyamoya sometimes is brought up when patients have symptoms that suggest poor blood supply to the brain. Those could be little spells where there's weakness or problems with speech or bad headaches. Sometimes people have other conditions like neurofibromatosis or sickle cell disease that we know have a higher risk of moyamoya, and that leads to getting some pictures. But once the question has been raised, the next step is to figure out the right tests. Usually we start with an MRI. And what an MRI does is it shows the brain itself. It may show if there are previous strokes, areas of injury in the brain. Not all strokes cause symptoms, some do. And then we also can see the actual blood vessels. And if the blood vessels are narrow or don't look healthy, and sometimes there's a lot of tiny vessels around them called collaterals. And the analogy there is just like if traffic is backed up on a major highway, all the traffic will go in the back roads and cause a lot of congestion on the little smaller side streets. That's exactly what blood does going into the brain. And that so-called puff of smoke, as it looks on x-ray pictures, is one of the classic findings of moyamoya. So we usually start with an MRI. We tend to look to see if the blood vessels are narrow. Are there areas of slow blood flow or so-called IV sign in the brain, which is an MRI finding? And then if those findings are there or at least suggestive, sometimes we'll do an angiogram, an x-ray test that involves going to sleep, getting a little needle or an IV type catheter in a blood vessel in the hip, and then some very fancy pictures, kind of like a movie, can be done with greater detail than an MRI that will help us sort of cinch the diagnosis many times. So that's really the workup we do. We start usually with an MRI, and then we'll go to the angiogram, and then often have a discussion with the family about what that looks like. And there's lots of intricacies and details about grading systems and specific findings, but in general, that's sort of the usual pathway we follow to make a diagnosis of moyamoya.